A reading from the letter of Paul to Romans, chapter 1, verse 16 to 17. For I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For in it the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the righteous shall live by faith. The word of the Lord. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, the moment when we read this verse, most of us would think that why will Paul be ashamed of preaching the good news? St. Paul, who is known as the father of faith, why is that? He is ashamed of preaching the good news. For I am not ashamed of the good news, says the Lord. St. Paul says, I am not ashamed of the good news. And how can we ever think that he will be ashamed of good news? When Paul was addressing the Christian community in Rome, the Rome which was a sophisticated city, a center of worldly power, and Paul was addressing that the gospel is the power of God and salvation for everyone who believes in it. And Paul is not ashamed of gospel because he knows it's godly power. As we see, the king on this earth can enjoy great power and authority on this earth, but we need to remember that his power and authority is limited, wherein God's power is infinite, transcendent, and has no limit. It has no end. So Paul has experienced this power of God, the power in the Word of God. As we know from his own life history, he experienced it on the road to Damascus, on his way when he was going to persecute the Christians. God's power manifested on him and changed him from Saul to Paul. And how he can be ashamed of the gospel. It is a totally controversy if we say that Paul would be ever ashamed of gospel. No. Because if today the Gentiles have become Christian, is because Paul brought Jesus to them in their life. Paul preached the gospel to the Gentile Christians. Similarly, Jesus also was a great missionary. And that's the reason the missionary Paul, St. Paul says that Jesus deserves to be exalted. His name has to be exalted above all other names because he obeyed the will of his Father and fulfilled his Father's will perfectly, even unto the death on the cross. And he paid the penalty for our sins. And thus he proved his victory over death through his resurrection. This is very important that we need to meditate, that Jesus also is a great missionary who preached his Father's will throughout his tenure on this earth. So when Paul, who is an ardent disciple, an apostle of Jesus, how can he ever be ashamed of this gospel? Wherein we see through his missionary journeys, Paul glories in the gospel and is proud of the gospel. In today's verse, Paul's main message was salvation. As we all know, what is salvation? Salvation is that how the sinners can be reconciled from God's righteous judgment and delivered from God's righteous judgment and reconciled to God, and thus in order to proclaim gospel boldly and ashamedly, we must first believe ourselves in salvation. It's very easy to say that, go and preach about salvation. But we need to understand that, first and foremost, we need to believe in what we preach. And we need to practice in what we preach. Only then, when we believe in ourselves, we can go and preach the gospel of God and salvation to others. I want to explore few things about the salvation that stems out from this text. The first thing is, salvation is the main need of every person. Because most of them, they say, why that is that salvation is so important in humankind, in human being? And why is that he has to pay penalty for the sins? But we need to understand, if there is no God's salvation, if there is no understanding in the love of God, in the mercy of God, we cannot attain that blissful solitude in the heavenly kingdom. Most of them say, if we basically remain as a good person, we don't need to work for salvation. And some even say that, why is Jesus to be crucified on the cross? And why do we need a crucified Savior? Only thing, if we have polished our life and we have learned some encouragement from our elders, how to live a happy living. Some hints on happy living is enough and sufficient to be a good human being. But we need to remember, we need the mercy of God, because by nature itself, we are ungodly under God's righteous wrath. The moment we are thrown into this world, we are thrown and we are born with sin, the original sin committed by our first parents. And only by the intercession of God in our life, we can deliver ourselves from the righteous judgment of God and we can attain salvation. Therefore, the gospel becomes good news to the person who first and foremost believes in the salvation personally, that he will be saved. The second thing is that salvation requires the very power of God. So salvation is not something that sinners can attain by their own efforts and of their own good works. Most of them, they'll say that only the sinner has to work in order to attain the salvation without the intercession or without the influence of divine. But if that was so, Christ need not have to die on the cross. Salvation is not a joint venture or a joint project where God has done his part and now he's asking us to do our own part, and we must contribute from our part to attain salvation. We need to remember, salvation does not depend on the human decision, but on the very power of God. We need the power of God in order to attain the salvation. See, in the life of Jesus, during his ministry on this earth, he cried out. In John chapter 11 verse 43, he says, Lazarus, come forth. Maybe the bystanders who were stand there might have thought that, is he gone crazy? He is speaking to a dead man who has been dead in tomb for 4 days. But the power of God through the word of Jesus imparted into the life of a dead man and he was resurrected. Also, we see in Matthew chapter 19 verse 23, when Jesus is commenting to his disciples, he says, truly I say to you, it is hard for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. Of course, the innocent disciples were astonished at the statement of Jesus. Then they questioned Jesus and said, then who can enter the kingdom of God? And Jesus replies in that gospel passage, with people, everything is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. In other words, salvation is from the Lord. And we require the very power of God to attain the salvation. My dear friends, look at the life of St. Paul. Even though having been a great student of Gamaliel, expert in Torah, but still he sacrificed everything after that encounter in Damascus. He sacrificed everything and he blindly believed in Lord Jesus Christ, and he was going on proclaiming the gospel to every corner of the world. As a true missionary, the essence of his life was to preach the gospel to others, and he was not ashamed and he was not timid in any moment of his life. Fearing not even for his life, he was ready to proclaim the gospel. Because he understood gospel is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes in it, and we must proclaim it boldly. But we see in today's generations, today's trends are so much that some are totally ashamed and even timid to preach gospel to others. Some feel even ashamed to even speak about Bible or even to carry a Bible in their office or in the place of their work because they feel it is something like a burden for them. And some of them even dodge warning people about the wrath of God because that is not much popular idea nowadays. And some of them even avoid preaching about Christ's bloodshed because the only remedy for our sins that Christ's bloodshed has bought us and redeemed us from sin. Some are even ashamed to tell that because for them it sounds that it is a kind of an old story or a primitive. And some of them even put positive spin on the gospel so that it sounds like a positive plan for how to have a happy life here and now on this earth, choosing certain things from the Bible to make them happy only on the earth and not working to attain salvation and to attain the kingdom of God in heaven. And all this aspect shows that we are ashamed nowadays to preach the truth of the gospel like the apostle St. Paul did in his life, always lived his gospel, lived the life of gospel, preached the gospel, and was ready to sacrifice his life for gospel. My dear friends, let us primarily understand, as a Christian, the gospel is what we are called to preach to others. First and foremost, we need to basically and personally understand the gospel. And we need to preach the gospel to ourselves every day, to our family members, to our neighbors, to our friends, and thus proclaim to the people who do not know the truth of the gospel. Unashamedly to others, especially for the people who are lost in this world. If we claim still our Christianity in this world is just in few percentage, is because we as a Christians, we as a followers of Christ, have not preached the faith what we have to others, rather because of our timidity and because that we feel ashamed to preach the gospel, keeping ourselves, still there are people who do not know Jesus. The primary duty of us is to preach gospel to others and win souls for the kingdom of God. As St. Paul is a beautiful example for all of us who preached gospel throughout his life and lived for the gospel and died for the gospel. And today as a saint is blessing us and giving us that encouragement to go and proclaim the gospel to the unknown and give Jesus to them and win souls for the greater glory of God. May Lord Jesus Christ, through the intercession of St. Paul, strengthen us to preach the gospel to the people who do not know him and ever ready to accept him in his life. Amen.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. All who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your peace.
down in adoration falling. Lo, the sacred host we hail. Lo, ancient forms departing. You were rites of grace away, faith for all defects supplying, where the feeble senses fade, to the everlasting Father. On high, with the Holy Ghost proceeding forth from each eternally. Be salvation, honor, blessings, might and endless majesty. Amen.
Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving